What's up, YouTube? Matt Voke, call sign Jerry. Today, we're going to look at OpenAI. How's a mustache doing? Happy Mustache March. And some of OpenAI's pursuits towards general intelligence, that artificial general intelligence is thought to be the holy grail of AI. They get after some of the challenges with machine-machine teaming and human-machine teaming, looking at cooperation and collaboration through one of the oldest games, Hide and Seek. Very simple, relatively straightforward game that doesn't take much intelligence, but Hide and Seek is a perfect environment for demonstrating how a human is able to sense and interact with objects in their environments over potentially long time horizons. You might have already heard me talk about long time horizons. Well, click above to watch the video of Alpha Star from DeepMind defeating StarCraft II experts. Long time horizons challenge AI and its understanding of its universe. A game of hide and seek would be extremely difficult if the seeker didn't remember where they looked last. Pretty straightforward. Like we've seen in previous games, reinforcement learning is great for training agents to perform desired tasks. But OpenAI is interested more than training the agents to perform specific tasks. They want to be able to generalize. Direct supervision does not scale. It's just that simple. You can't tag and train a robot, an AI, to do everything that they're potentially going to see in the future. Nor does it allow them to work in complex, unbounded situations. When the environment changes just a little bit, traditionally trained models need to start learning completely over again. They don't have the generalized ability to apply their previous learning to that new situation. Anyways, Hide and Seek is one of those games that requires several human relevant skills, including collaborative tool use, which is pretty dang cool if you watch these videos. These agents have to work together to change the environment to suit their needs in order to win at the game. All right, enough intro. So what specifically has OpenAI done here and why is this important? What are these agents doing? Watch this. These agents are teamed up in games of Hide and Seek. Hiders avoid the line of sight of the seekers, and the seekers try to keep vision of the hiders. Pretty simple. Agents get rewarded by not being found or finding the others, depending on their team. They are not told how to interact with the environment, or are they incentivized to do so. They learn that on their own. That's the second good part here, is emergent learning. Emergent behaviors and strategies emerge based on these multi-agent competitions. No behaviors were specifically taught or incentivized to these agents. They learned all of this, and this is emergent on their own. That's amazing if you want to think about it. After 25 million episodes of Hide and Seek, the hiders learned to use the tools to intentionally modify the environment. 25 million episodes may be a lot, but that's pretty amazing emergent discovery. They learn that they can block themselves into rooms. Pretty incredible. Not only are they running away, but they're able to box themselves into a room and not be found. After 75 million episodes, the seekers then learn that they can use these rudimentary tools to their advantage. Watch them as they discover how to use the ramp to jump into these closed rooms made by the hiders. Another 10 million episodes later, the hiders learn to lock the ramps to defend against the seeker's use. Wow, AI's learned to sabotage its adversary. Great, good job OpenAI. After about another 380 million training episodes, the seekers learn that they could bring a box over to the edge of the play area, get on top of that box, and then surf it into the hider's safe house. This is some crazy stuff. 380 million training episodes have allowed these agents to emergently find this innovative strategy. This is pretty crazy. Another cool aspect of OpenAI's development here that is easily overlooked is that these agents are required to cooperate and coordinate their actions. You can see that both of the agents are blocking off their shelter and they're splitting up to better acquire the hiders. It may not seem great, but there's obvious applications beyond games for this AI and its capability to cooperate and coordinate. Finally, I'd like to swing back to what we first discussed. For OpenAI's attempt of why they're doing this in the first place is that generalization of intelligence, the holy grail of AI, is far more important than just rewarding what the AI trains specifically in very narrow areas. This AI isn't just beating games. It's developing some sort of general intelligence that's able to cross from one domain of learning to another. To this end, the team created 5 intelligence tests where the hide-and-seek agents were asked to count objects, perform sequential tasks, and to create unique structures. Agents were already trained in hide-and-seek showed an increased ability generalized in these new intelligence tasks over models that were not previously trained or were trained by older systems or methods. This demonstrated that there was generalization in these agents' learning because they could cross into new tasks. Although the difference was slight and there is room for improvement, this is still important. Coordination, cooperation, and learning emergent behavior and strategy is awesome.
Is this not why you are here?
It's pretty easy to see that cooperation and coordination is extremely beneficial for any multi-agent application of AI, or specifically in human-machine teaming, or machine-machine teaming. The AI and the human won't be very efficient or effective if both are operating irrespective of the other's actions or intent. They need to be able to work together. If the multiple agents are working together, they can more effectively and efficiently accomplish their tasks if integrated well. The easiest way to demonstrate this is with game theory. Have you heard of the prisoner's dilemma? It's a very simple game where 2 people are being interrogated by the police. Someone has committed a crime, and the police are intent on pinning it on one or both of these crooks. The crooks can either rat out their buddy or stay silent. The Nash equilibrium in these cases are significantly different if the crooks are able to talk to one another and cooperate. If they can coordinate and cooperate, their incentives are absolutely in line to shut their mouths and not rat on their buddy. If they cannot coordinate and cooperate, they will ultimately fall on ratting out their buddy, and then they both get longer jail sentences. This is significantly better outcome because they can talk to each other, aka cooperate. Great. So what about emergent behaviors and emergent strategies? This is another really cool example area from this OpenAI learning. In the example of hide and seek, agents learn at least 7 emergent strategies, some of which would be extremely difficult to learn through traditional training models and methods. Let's analyze this emergently learned strategy compared to some of our approaches to training and wargaming. Just like we talked about in the last video on AlphaStar and StarCraft. In 2016, when AlphaGo defeated Lee Sedol in Go, some of AlphaGo's emergent behaviors shocked the world. The humans even declared these moves mistakes.
That's a very surprising move.
I thought you thought it was a mistake.
They quickly changed their tone, though, minutes later, when they realized that emergent behavior that nobody has ever seen before that they thought was mistakes was able to set that AI up to defeat that grandmaster in the long term. Experts are still learning from AI's novel and unbounded approach to games like Go, like hide and seek, where emergent behaviors are learned without the use of heuristics from humans or in the box thinking, prepping those humans. Amazing. These are exciting times indeed. It's awesome that we're able to glean so much from these AI playing such simple games. I can't wait to see what these guys come up with next on their path to artificial general intelligence. The application surface and room for improvement in areas from swarm cooperation to operational strategy are boundless. We ought not rest on our laurels and should be applying some of these great lessons learned from academia and the corporate world. Great stuff. If you guys stuck out this long, you should definitely hit the subscribe so you can be alerted automatically when I release some future content that you're probably also going to like. Hit the like, thumbs up please, and I would love some comments. Definitely let me know what you guys like. Give me some feedback. Hey, I didn't like this. Recommend you do this so that I can prove this for you guys in the future. I like putting these out for you guys to inform you on what's happening and then how we potentially can use that. So please let me know how I can improve this in the content. Thanks. See ya.